video, Instagram just showed me a memory from 2 years ago when I was closing on the house that I live in. That was a very stressful time for me. They say real estate agents should buy a house every few years so they can realize and understand the stress and the pressure that their clients are under. But I think my situation was a little bit unique because I was selling the house that I was living in. I was buying the house that I was moving to. I was in contract for 1, 2, 3, 4 more houses for myself. And I had 18 clients under contract. So my 18 clients who I was helping them either buy or sell a house, then I had six transactions at the time for myself. So the 5 houses that I was buying and the one I was selling. The 5 that I was buying and the 1 that I was selling and the 18 for my clients. Then I'm very cheap and I'm very frugal, so I decided I'm going to be my own general contractor for these houses. I don't need a contractor. I could do everything myself. I know plumbers. I know this. I know that. I could paint this house myself. I could do this. I could do that. Wrong. When I was planning all of this in my head, I didn't take into consideration the workload I already have on me. Like I said, I had 18 clients in contract to either buy or sell a house. I own a real estate brokerage, so I'm helping the agents with their files. I just have a lot of stuff going on, so that was a bad idea. So I said the next time I decide, and then I was doing everything by myself. I didn't have nobody helping me with anything, and because I had a problem asking for help, but that's a whole nother story. But I said the next time I decide to do something where it's like so many things going on at once, I will not do it by myself, because one of my friends told me cheap people pay for things twice. And that's so true, because I ended up having to stop construction of the houses because things were not going right. People weren't being overseen the way they needed to be, because my priority is my clients. I understand that I was buying houses, but my priority is always my clients. So my stuff just went to the side. Stopped construction, so I have these houses that's just sitting. So essentially, to me, I'm losing money. If a house is just sitting, it's not making me any money. I'm losing money. So I paid more money trying to do things myself when I was doing it to save money, but I would have saved money just paying a general contractor, paying a project manager, because it was so many things going on at once. But I'm sharing this story because smart people learn through others. So if you have a lot of things going on, even if you don't, think about your overall situation first and don't try to do everything yourself, because you probably will end up costing yourself more money. I know for me, I did. And I said the next time I decide to do something with so many things and I already have a lot going on, I'm not doing it. No matter how easy I think it'll be, I'm not gonna do it. So I hope you learn from me. Bye.